The first structure on this corner was owned by Samuel Van Wyck Fleet and called Fleet's Hall, a site of many village gatherings in the late 19th century. Complete with a stage and large seating area, people gathered here to see shows on the Magic Lantern, a Victorian device that projected glass plate images onto a wall or screen. In 1905, a traveling show presented the first motion picture in Oyster Bay at Fleet's Hall. People liked it so much that regular showings began in 1908. The price of a movie ticket, 25 cents. Town residents held meetings here, attended concerts, receptions, dances, and dinners. And a local team called the Sagamore Stars played basketball on the spacious second floor. When Theodore Roosevelt ran for governor in 1898, great crowds gathered at Fleet's Hall to watch election results, transmitted simultaneously with New York City. And when the colonel won, a large reception was held. In 1910, William H. Nobman bought Sylvester Holmes' hardware business on East Main Street, and then in 1925, purchased the Fleet's Hall building, which since its heyday had become a grocery called the Modern Market. Mr. Nobman wanted to build a new structure and placed an ad in the local newspaper to sell the old building to the highest bidder, so long as they, quote, removed it at once. The Modern Market moved across the street to the Moores Building, and Old Fleet's Hall was removed. But the wood planks remained in Oyster Bay. They were used in the construction of other buildings around town. William Nobman built the new home for his hardware emporium with a bell tower and clock facing in the four directions of the compass. The exterior was painted to resemble reddish-brown marble. Later, this was covered with a faux brick and later yet with the current aluminum siding. Derek Nobman is currently running the hardware store, following in the footsteps of four generations of his family.